Hey, it's Rich, the Louisiana Hobby Guy. Today's video, I'm going to revisit an older video and remake it, and we're going to call this one Creating a Laser Bed Template for Production Runs. A lot of people ask questions about framing. They waste time on framing, and they try all types of little tricks and tips and that people are giving out on discussion boards on how to frame an object and so on. And really, if you just create some cardboard templates, you won't ever have to frame again. If you're doing production items like slate tiles, round coasters, dog tags, business cards, whatever it might be, you can create a template to do that. Put the template down on your bed and just pop the items in and out of it. Make it real simple. And that's what we're going to do today. So we're going to get started, and I'm going to grab a rectangle over here. I'm going to draw it out. I'm going to make sure that the lock is unlocked up here. And I'm using an ortur 20 watt laser that has a bed of 400 by 430. So I'm going to make this 380. I'm going to press tab by 410 and press enter. Now, if I select it, I'll move it right onto the bed here, giving me just a little more room than I need. And you may ask why I'm making it smaller. Well, the reason why is because ortur is very cheap on their wiring, and they give you just enough wire to make it back here. But on my machine, the way I have my wires routed so that they don't get tangled, it's just a few millimeters short. So I operate within this 380 by 410 area. This way I don't have to worry about it going out of bounds or locking up and stopping in the middle of the burn. I know this will burn the 380 by 410 on my bed without causing any problems. So with that said, I'm going to come up here to cuts and layers. I'm going to double click on that layer. I'm going to set my speed for 800, and I'm going to set my power to 90%, and I'm going to do constant power mode. And actually, I think I'm going to set this to 900, and that's good just like that. And that's all we need right there. So I'm going to say okay. And I'm going to save this file, run over to the laser, because I'm not plugged into the laser with this computer. So I'm going to run over, run this file, burn my wasteboard, and then I'll be right back. Okay, so here's the wasteboard finished. Now, all I did was run a pass on that. It didn't come out quite right. So I ran another pass, and then I lowered my focus and ran a third pass. Now I have a nice dark burn, and that's my base. What we're going to do is we're going to use cardboard templates. I'm going to cut some cardboard at the measurements that I have this rectangle, 380 by 410. And I'm going to make sure that these two sides here are factory edges, the left side and the bottom side. And that's all I have to line up. I don't have to line anything else up, because if I line up two factory edges, it's going to be perfect all the way around. Now, I get these cardboards in 4x4 sheet that they use for pallets, but you can use anything. You can use a large Amazon box, you know, any type of cardboard. You can pick up some cardboard from Hobby Lobby, Lowe's, Home Depot has it, and get a few of them, because you're going to want to make all different templates. So now that I've got my template, I'm going to click on it to select it, make sure all the handles are showing, and I'm going to come down here to T1 on the color palette, and I'm going to set that one to a toolpath. So now this one won't ever burn again. Now what I have to do, I'm going to make this one for my 4-inch slate tiles. So I'm going to grab another rectangle. I'm going to draw it out on my work bed. I'm going to come down to the color palette, set it to the 00 layer, make sure that it's selected. I'm going to come up here, change this from millimeters to inches. I know my slate tiles are exactly 4 inches, so I'm going to type 4, tab 4, enter. Now I have the exact size of my slate tile. I'm going to drop it right here. The next thing I'm going to do is come down to make an array. So we're going to create an array of these. I'm going to click on make array. I'm going to do 3 columns, and I'm going to do 3 rows. And that's what I know I can fit on here. Now they're a little too close together. So I'm going to space these out, and I'm going to give myself enough space here because we just have the space, so I may as well use it. And I'm going to space it out vertically. And that looks good, like that. Now we have plenty of space in between them. So now that we've got enough space, I'm going to come back up here to cuts and layers, If I right click on this, you'll see that all of the black layer will flash. I'm going to double click on it. And this one I'm going to do a little bit differently because we have to cut it. So we want to cut these squares out. So I'm going to change my speed to 500. And it's cardboard, so it should cut through on one pass. If it doesn't cut through on one pass, we could just run the job again until it does cut through. But I'm guessing that 500 should be about right. I don't want to burn the cardboard light or ignite it on fire, so any lower than that I think would be too much. So I'm going to do 590, constant power mode, in line, and that's all we need to do, and say okay. Now I'm going to run back over to the laser again, and I'm going to cut these out. Okay, so here we are. This is the final product. And we have a few little scrap squares to play with. 9 4-inch squares. I guess we can do test burns on them in the future. But this is the final product. And I decided to change my settings a little bit. I lowered the speed to 400 and power at 90 because it's been raining a lot here every day here in New Orleans. I'm not working in the air conditioned workshop. It's being remodeled. I'm in the garage. So everything is soaking up the humidity. And I'm glad that I switched to 490. I did also do two passes. I had to cut just a couple of them out, a couple little bits and pieces here and there, but most of it came out just fine. Now you can see if I take that cardboard and line it up with this edge and this edge. So I'm going to use the factory edge of that cardboard and line it up on this side and the bottom. That's all I have to line up. Everything else is fine. Now this red line is representing the burn that I did on the waste board, and you see that's on the tool path, so that didn't burn. It just cut out the squares for me. Now what we're going to do, we're going to make these squares that have been cut out a tool path as well as offset them, because I have 4-inch slate coasters. They fit perfectly in here, but I can't burn the whole 4 inches because the slate has, you know, the chipped edges. So what I'm going to do is just select all of these. I'm going to come over here to offset shapes. I'm going to click on this, bring this up, and I'm going to do 0.95, I think, but let's do 0.99 and say okay. Now that will give us enough room on the edges so that we won't burn on the little slope part and the chips going all around the edges. You don't need to do this with everything. If you're doing the little round coasters made out of wood, you don't need the offset at all. But on the slate coasters, I do. And the last step to do is we're going to select them all again. And we're going to also put these on the tool path down on the bottom, T1 on the color palette. So now all of this is a tool path and nothing will burn now. All you have to do at this point is load this template. So we're going to do file, save as, and I already have it, laser template production. I already have it named. So I'm going to save that. And now anytime I want to burn a slate tile, I'll load this. I will never frame again. I will load this. I'll take my cardboard. I'll line up these two sides right here on my workbed with the cardboard. I'll grab a graphic. Let's say I want to do one right this minute. Just grab one, snap it right into the middle. Did you see how it snapped right into the middle? Hold control, scale it to size. That's about what I want right there. All I have to do now is set my speed, my power, okay, send it to the laser, and it's done. No more framing, ever. You can create these templates for everything, and it doesn't matter how many you do, whether you do 1, 2, 3, 5, doesn't matter where you do them. You can do them in the center of the bed. You can press Control and D and duplicate it so that we can do two of them and put one there. Now all I have to do is drop in two slate tiles in these two squares and hit start. It's a beautiful thing. Here's an example. Now here you can see in this picture, I dropped the slate square right into the middle slot. Didn't have to frame, didn't have to do anything. I loaded my artwork, hit start, and that's the end of it. It's done. How easy is that? I hope this video helped you out. Thank you for watching.